Well, there you have it. So today we watched the president in an emotional visit at Buchenwald concentration camp today with German Chancellor Angela Merkel and Elie Wiesel. A significant trip coming on the heels of his speech reaching out to Muslims around the world.
And tomorrow's trip to Normandy marks the 65-year anniversary of the D-Day invasion. President Obama will hear firsthand accounts from some of the men who fought there and survived one of World War II's bloodiest and most important battles. Here to share his memories is Tom Blakey. He parachuted onto Normandy before dawn on June 6, 1944, with the 82nd Airborne. He joins us live from New Orleans, the home of the National World War II Museum. And, sir, it is a true honor to have you on the show today. By the clock that I look at right now, 65 years ago, at this moment, you were about 10 hours or so from the D-Day invasion. What went through your head at that time, sir, that long ago?
We were very anxious to go. We had been put off the night before. Everybody was very quiet. There was two ways of getting home, a bad wound and a trip through France and Germany, which everybody wanted, and this was the first big step.
Sir, talk to me a little bit about once you got on the ground, you know, what it was like for you. You land in the dark of night, and you landed, I think, somewhere near St. Mary Glees, right?
St. Marcouf.
Okay. What did it feel like? You know, you're a 21-year-old, I think, 22 maybe at the time?
22. Well, everybody has fear, you know. You're looking around, and it's dark, and you know you're dropping right in the middle of a bunch of Germans, so you've got to take care of yourself, move around a little bit as much you can, and just before daylight, with six of us had gotten together, and we started looking around for a road sign or something to tell where we were. If we could find out where we were, we would know where to go. Mm-hmm. It was just a matter of circumstances. Nobody was upset.
Sir, do you think 65 years ago, do you think today that people realize that when you see the world as it exists and you see Americans and then the freedom that we cherish, do you think they realize the sacrifices that you and your colleagues made on that day 65 years ago?
No, I do not. And you're forgetting about the home front. The home front was more important. It was people who did a job as well as we did. We couldn't have done it without them.
Sir, before I let you go, I just want to ask you, you said that the first time you saw a concentration camp, it had a big impact on you. Tell me about that.
Friends and myself, too, wondered, during the war, why are we here? What have I done to deserve this? We all found out why we were there when we saw our first camp.
Sir, we thank you so much for how much you've served this country and you served the world and the cause of freedom around the world. And we're so glad that we had a chance to talk to you today. We'll be watching the president's trip, of course, to Normandy and ensure that he will feel the impact of so many of the things that you're saying to us today. And we thank you so much for being with us, Mr. Blakey. Good
pleasure
to have you.
Nice, thank you.
Terrific guy.